Stanley Cups here on Sunrise, but check this out. A Blaine woman has a not-so-secret obsession with Stanleys. Gina Staples has been collecting them with her daughter for a few years now. She's got a grand total, I just texted her yesterday, 49 of them. She keeps them on display in her kitchen hutch, and she doesn't plan on stopping her growing collection anytime soon.
They only put so many out there, and then, you know, you, like, want all of them. And I really like just being able to go and, like, match your outfits.
Gina runs the Facebook group Stanley Cup Hunters of Minnesota and tells me that she never plans to sell any of her tumblers, even if they're worth thousands of dollars.
One of the most mind-boggling things of my lifetime will be the Stanley Cup craze.
You know, is this going to be like the Pokemon cards and the, you know, it could be worth something later?
Well, like, is Yeti dead?
No, I love my Yeti. Yeti.
But it's not, it doesn't have the same status as, you know.
Right. I mean, there's absolutely no way this lasts forever. Right. The poor company is probably going to be like, what do we do when this tanking?
New colors.
It'll run out.
Keep the hype.
What else are they going to do? Like thermoses? That ain't going to be cool.
No, thermoses. Why would anybody want
granted, those things are like cool. A thermos. Have you seen that?
It's cute.
Like, we should get like neck things. You can like put it around your neck.
Neck thermoses.
There you go, Stanley.